starting from the previous days. Class, has any one of you just tried to solve that circuit? Only if you can solve the circuit, then it will be easier for you to understand. Okay. As of now, I want at least some of you to solve it and show it to me. Only then I will tell you whether it is right or wrong. Okay, you need to give some. No, I have solved it. There have been people who have solved it, but they were not correct. But I want others to also try it out. Like Soumya, she made she tried it. I'll just tell you how to do it once again, okay? And then I will start off to the other part of the topic. So I'll start up my presentation, like I'll share my screen, okay? And I tell you, I will show you the procedure. Just wait a second. Okay, I'm sharing the screen now. Tell me if my screen is visible to you.
No, sir.
It's still not visible. Just wait. Just tell me when it happens. It might take some time. I don't know. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. So I'll just repeat what I have told you previously. Soumya, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you realize what mistake you made in the thing you gave me?
Yes, sir. Rows and columns, elements.
Yeah. So it was the graph was like this, right? You have three nodes. Three nodes and three elements. Of them, two of them were branches. And the other one was the link. Okay. Your matrix, the bus incidence matrix that will form like this, you'll have on the column side, how many columns you'll have?
Two
columns. Okay. So column one and column two. And on the row side, how many will you have?
Three.
On the row side, you'll have three. I'll try to remember. I think I've given you this circuit. Let us all solve this one today. Ramra, you're there?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. You asked me yesterday about the circuit, so let us solve this one. So this is a current. I'm just taking a random value. Values are not important, you see. Okay, let's say this can be 1 ampere. Okay, and this is becomes 2 ampere. This is 3, and this is 7. I guess I took it as 7, and this is 5. All of you take out your papers, like it will be helpful if you do it along with me. So how many elements we are having? Soumya, how many elements will be having?
3, sir. 3
elements, okay. Of which one is two will be branch. Yes. So I will name the branches as 1 and branch 2, and the link as branch 3. Okay. So in the matrix, you will have the upper part as for the branches, and lower part is for the links. Okay. Can you tell me the first element in this branch? Bus incidence matrix, first element.
1.
Why it is 1? Okay, let us take this as. Tell me. So the first element, hello, am I audible to you? Yeah. So the first element is A11. I'm following this convention. A11 is what? Now look at this A11. It is bus one and the element. So element 1 connected to bus 1. Okay. So element 1, this is the element that is connected to the bus 1. Now before that, we need to this is a graph, okay, and you need to give the graph some orientation. I'll just make this arrows are not important. Just you have to give it a direction that your value may be negative. That is unimportant, but you have to give some arrow. Now if I say 11, A11 is the branch 1, node 1. Branch 1 is connected to node 1? Yes. Branch 1 is connected to node 1. That means the value would be either plus 1 or minus 1. Now, is the direction is outwards node 1? Yes. Then the value would be plus 1. Clear or not? Pavan, you are there? Pavan, you are there? Pundalik? Bhumika?
Yeah,
can you tell me this one, this A12? What would be the value?
1, 2, sir,
minus 1.
Because it is moving towards 1, no, sir, that's why -1.
-1.
No. 1, 2, I am talking, consider this. On your row, you are talking about the branch or the link. Right. So, okay. Now your check is that I am talking about the first branch and the second node. First
it's
branch.
Zero. It's zero. Yes,
it is not connected to the second node. Okay. Tell me this one. A21. To be a practice.
Zero, sir.
So we are talking of the second branch and first node.
First node.
Again, it is yeah. Ramrai, you tell me the this one.
Zero.
It will be zero. I think the second.
No, sir. I'm asking why.
Oh, why? Why it is zero? Because, see. Let's go back to this circuit. Okay. Do you remember this? Try to visualize this.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just visualize this. You are able to see it, right? Properly.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, look at this element. This element in this matrix A11. A11 tells you this row is 1, the column is 1. The row is tells you about the element, the column tells about the node. Okay. Now the first element and first node. You look at here, first element and first node. This is element number 1. This is element number 1. This is node number 1. First element is connected to the first node. That means the value will be either plus 1 or minus 1. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, since we are talking about the node, we'll talk it as a direction or current. The current goes out, or the direction is outside of the node, it will be plus 1.
Mm-hmm.
Now, take the second one. A12. Now we are talking about the first node, sorry, first element and second node. First element and second node. First element is not connected to second node.
Mm.
So if it is not connected, you will have a zero. If it is connected, you have one or minus one. Now you have to check the direction. If the direction is outwards of the node, it is plus one. If it is inside the node, it is minus one. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now, similarly, tell me about this one. See, you have a element 2, that is this element. This is the element 2. Change the color of the light. This element 2, node 2. Element 2 is connected to node 2. Obviously, it will be plus 1 or minus 1. Now,
minus
1. This is, yes. It will be minus 1 because now the direction it enters. Okay. Now let us take the third one. It is a link. Okay. Sania, you tell me the first answer.
So zero.
Element 3 connected to 1. No, element 3 is connected to 1.
Minus 1, sir.
Minus 1. Sir. So it is not connected, no, sir. But
well, element is the element, third element is connected.
So this
to
is a link, no?
It is a link, but I'm talking about the element. Element E is equal to branch and link.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So this link, you see, you see the first half. Are you able to see it properly? I'll zoom it out for you.
So your screen is not visible.
There is, has been a connection problem. I'm just I'm trying to get in.
Hello, am I audible now? Hello, am I audible now to all of you?
Yes, sir.
There was some connection. I lost the connection actually. I'm trying to share it once again.
Yes, sir.
Just tell me if when you're able to see my screen. Tell me when you are able to see my screen.
So it is visible now.
Okay, thank you. So I'll start again. So Sunny, I just I'll just tell you. You look at this matrix. The first top part, you have this element. The top parts are the branches. The lower half rows are the links. Okay. So the same matrix holds for the branches as well as the links. That this side it comes as the nodes. Okay. Similarly, you are having here. We had this number three. Element number three is a node. Element number three is connected to one, but the direction is towards one. So it is minus one. And obviously, this element is connected to two also. It should be plus one. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, one more interesting thing, if you want to see, the sum of the rows will be zero. The sum of the elements in the rows for the links would be zero. Did you see?
Yes, sir.
Yes, that is one of the check, which means actually that the links are actually the link. They do not set the direction of current. Okay, they help to connect the network. So that's why. Wherever the line, I mean the direction you place, the sum of the elements of the row for the links, remember for the links only, will be zero. Check this one. Minus one plus one. Okay. Now, for the branches, it will not be zero. Here, they are all one. But for this case, it is minus one because I have made, possibly I have used this direction. Actually, if you look it properly, okay, the direction would be something else. If I take in this direction, it would have been plus one. For the branches, if you add the elements along the row, it will be non-negative, non-zero. But for the links, it would be zero. That is one of the checks. So the branch incidence matrix 1, 0, 0, -1, -1, +1. This is your branch incidence matrix for this. Okay. Now, what is your bus VBUS, one is here, this point. Voltage at this point, and voltage at V2. Okay. Now, what if I multiply these two, what will I get? If I multiply these two, what will I get? We are multiplying these two. I'll get three equations. V1 plus 0 V2. 0 V1 minus V2 minus V1 plus V2. Right? Tell me if you are not able to understand. If I multiply this, tell me, just calculate and tell me. You should tell me if you are not getting it, please do tell me. This has so much been here, right? Just I'll repeat it once again, but do not keep it in your mind. Tell me down and now. Then only you'll be able to understand. Anyone having a problem? Anyone having a problem? Am I audible to all of you, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Sunny, are you able to multiply these two matrices?
Yes, sir.
So, are you getting this kind of a value, this kind of an equation? It's an equation, this is a... So,
yes,
remember, what does it mean? If I multiply, understand this, please. If I multiply the bus incidence matrix with the bus matrix, I will get this V. What is this V? These are the voltage across the elements. These are the voltage across the elements. That means what? What am I getting from here? I am getting, I'll change a different color, let's see. So I am getting VB1 is equal to this. I am getting VB2 equal to this. I am getting VL3 equal to this. That means what I am getting is the voltage across these branch, the voltage across this, and the voltage across this. Okay, so VB1 is the voltage across the branch 1. What is the branch? This is the branch 1. What is the voltage across this branch? It is V1 itself, because this one is a ground position, right? So you'll have V1 only. What is V2? V2 is minus V2, because you see the current direction is this side. That is why you have a minus. Okay. Now, are you able to get it, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So unless and until you get it, then it will be difficult for me to like work, no? So again, the last part, VL3 is the voltage across this link. That is V2 minus V1. So you V2 minus V1. So you are from this multiplying the bus incidence matrix with the bus matrix, you are getting the matrix of the voltage across the elements. Now you ask me, to usse kya hoga? what you are getting now is that now you see what for these every element of the graph in the actual circuit you have different elements. Now for like for example the link which is connecting node 1 and node 2 is actually a register here of 7. Okay, now since I got the value of well, I was again outside. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I was again out, and I was speaking to I don't know whom. Fine. Okay. So I'm again starting my presentation. Okay. Now, are you able to multiply the bus incidence matrix and the bus node voltage matrix?
Yes.
Now, you have seen that if I multiply these two matrices, we are getting the branch or the element, the voltage across the element, right? Now, what is the use of it? When you get the voltage across the element, you know what actually the element is. For example, the link here is actually a resistor here. Okay, we know the voltage across this resistor. So the current across this resistor, that is IL3, will be nothing but VL3/7. Is it clear to all of you? Hopefully I'm still there. Is it clear to all of you? Tell me if you have any problem, just tell me. Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Just tell me, are you understanding it or I have to repeat? Tell me.
Yes, sir, understanding, sir.
Okay, so can you tell me the expression of the current through resistor 3? Ram Rai, can you tell me the expression? If I want to know what is the current through resistor 3, What will you say?
We be 1/3.
Yes. No, in terms of the branch voltage, it is V1 by 3, right, exactly. Again, for the across the 5, it will be V2 by 3. Now, your question is, sir, why do we need to do all these? Okay, for your in the circuit analysis, we have solved the circuit with this Kirchhoff's laws and all. Okay, you've taken if you remember the circuit analysis, you have these three currents. This I1, if you write in the circuit analysis, minus I1 is equal to V/3 plus V1 minus V2 by 7. Fine, those are okay. But the thing is that you are talking up now, I'm giving you a small circuit. It is nothing. This circuit is like, it's actually nowhere close to what you actually is there in the power system. There are thousands and thousands of buses, and what you can get from the data is the bus voltages. You'll be provided with the bus voltages. Now, if you know the bus voltages, you do not know what are the elements are there, but you know the connection, so you can understand the graph. Like, you'll have this kind of buses. You can have these kind of connections. You have a bus here that is connected to this bus, that connected to this bus, then this bus. You can see the how complicated this can be. These are all the I'll just write with a different color. These are all buses. These are all buses. You can see how difficult. I have only used 7 buses now. Think of 100 bus, 200, 10,000 bus. So then these matrices are important. Okay. So I'll just go to the next part. Is that we have seen what happens if you multiply this A with the V bus, you'll get the buses of the branch. Okay. I want you, this is your homework, I want you to write this circuit like this expression, I plus J equal to Y AV. Okay. Now, continuing further, if we pre-multiply with A transpose, now again somewhat have had any problem with A transpose, what is the transpose of this? Your rows becomes column and your column become rows. So the transpose of this would be what?
2 cross 3 1 0 minus 1 0 minus 1 1 0 minus 1 and 0 minus 1 1.
ठीक है सो योर रो बिकम्स अ कॉलम एंड योर कॉलम बिकम्स अ रो सो इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई द ए ट्रांसपोज टू एवरी वन दिस ए ट्रांसपोज इन टू आई इट टेल्स यू दिस इज नथिंग बट the algebraic sum of I at a particular node. Since by the Kirchhoff's law, the algebraic sum of I at a particular node is zero, A transpose of I is nothing but zero. Okay, so this element, the left-hand side element is gone. If you multiply with the A transpose, So what you have is A transpose J equal to A transpose Y A V bus. Okay. Now A transpose J is nothing but J bus. It is like the bus current that is injected inside. Okay. So this is what you have as the final equation. That is J bus equal to A transpose Y A V bus. From here, you can say that this Y bus would be nothing but you have this primitive Y multiplied by both sides as A and A transpose. Okay. Now, primitive Y you have found out. Like I'll do one. I'll share one. This one of this example. So this is how you find the Y bus. You have to find the primitive Y, then you have to find the A matrix, that is the bus incidence matrix. Then you have to post.
Hello. There is some connection. Hello, am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
There has been some connection problem. I'll continue in the next class. Okay. Just write your name. Hello. There's some connection problem. Just write your name and you leave the class. Okay. I'll continue in the next class. Just write your name and you leave. There's been some connection problem here. The internet is gone. Okay.
टेंशन में आ गया मैं कुछ तो हुआ है बीच में छोड़ दीजिए सर जो बोलने का नहीं है ये सुनने का नहीं है मैं सोचता हूँ ये आई वेंचर्स चीज क्या है भाई दो नंबर को यार पांच नंबर का पैसा तो यही देता है आपको थोड़ी ना इसमें रख रख के अभी अभी गिरेगा हो गया टाइम आ गया टाइम आ गया है शेयर गिरेगा ये तो नहीं बस बोले कुछ 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 क
Hello. ये वाला एरिया में मैक्सिमम होने की यही थे, मतलब मैं कहाँ से जाता यहाँ पे? पहाड़ से कहीं जाता है आपका आरएसआई भी है क्या? स्टोकेस्टिक आरएसआई दैट कैन से यू यू नॉट गेन गेन एनी बहुत आर लीडिंग इन दिस व्हाट यू टेल यू कैन से वो तो इस तरह से करते हैं तो मतलब सब आपका डिफरेंट व्यूज आएंगे, अब सभी सभी बोल रहे हैं, आप कह सकते सब टीम मेंबर्स बोल रहे हैं। हाँ सर भाई